It's my maestro, baby.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Anyways, and everybody voted for the time I got scammed on my first Tinder date. Dun dun dun. This is what happened. I would show you receipts, but I deleted the app because they banned me for those 3 months. I'm still salty. It's okay. I deleted the app and I'm done with it. Nothing good comes from Tinder. So this story happened 3 freaking years ago. I was fresh to Tinder. My friend and I, let's call her Cookie. Cookie. I joined Tinder with my friend. It was a joke. It was just to see like who's on it and who's around and who would we match with. And this is like the time when Tinder was like getting like super popular. It's not really that popular now. Now it has like a bad reputation. At the time, it was like everybody was on Tinder. Me and my friend Cookie, we just wanted to see what was out there just for fun. Not really to meet anyone or hang out with anyone. And if we were, it was gonna be, we're going together. Because you can't trust people out here. Like, we don't want to get kidnapped or sold or whatever. And then I matched with a couple people. The guy that's pertinent to the story, let's call him Kebab. Yeah, Kebab. We started talking, blah, 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 blah. Like,
hey, how are you?
Like,
where do you go to school? Do you wear it? Blah, blah, blah.
You know, normal conversation. We're just talking. The more we started talking on Tinder, he starts saying,
you know what? We should hang out.
And I told my friend Cookie, like, oh, this dude wanna hang out, but I don't know, I don't wanna meet anyone off of this website because you just don't know. Like, he kept pressing this issue for like 2 weeks. Like, every day he would like,
what are you doing? What's up? Like, we should hang out, let's get hookah.
All he would always say, like, let's get freaking hookah. So you know what? After the 2 weeks, I was talking to Cookie about it and she was like,
you know what? Just go. Like, he seems like, oh, he really wants to take you out or get to know you or whatever. If he keeps asking and he's persistent about it, just go. Just go. Just, what could happen? You have my number. If something happens to you, just call me.
So I was just like, you know what? I'll just freaking do it. Let's see what happens, you know? What could possibly happen? I texted Kebab and I was like, you know what? Yeah, let's go. Let's do it. So fast forward, the day came. Since I was going on a date, you know what? I wanted to be off leak. I wanted to just be on. I was getting ready and he was texting me. Okay, the first red flag I should freaking listen to. He was really pushy about me letting him know when I was leaving the house. Like, he was like,
let me know why you leave the house and if you're gonna be late because I don't want to be waiting around.
Which is understandable. That's how I like took it at the time. But I'll tell you why I was like a little bit suspicious. I started thinking like, why is he pressing it? Because he kept saying it and he was saying it in like a tone where it was like almost pushy, like pressing the issue. Like, either this guy drove with an Uber and he doesn't want to wait around, or he just doesn't like people wasting his time. But he was like getting a little bit aggressive, so I was just like, yeah, I'll tell you when I get there. So he sent me the address. I was done getting ready. I told him I'm leaving the house, blah, blah, blah. And I was like a little bit late, like not that late, like a couple minutes. I drove there, I got there, met up with him. Thank God he looked like his freaking picture. And thank God he looked like my freaking picture. Anyways, ooh, we go in. He already ordered. He ordered hookah, he ordered his own drinks already. He was like situating. Yeah, we went in, we're having a good time. We're smoking the hookah he already ordered. Having a good time, talking, getting to know each other. And then it's getting late, right? So he starts thinking, if I don't make a move now, ease her on into my intentions. So he started getting really touchy-feely, like touchy-feely, and I was getting uncomfortable, and I was kind of like dodging. I was just like, relax, like take a hint. Like, I was just like basically like dodging, dipping, like if I see the hand going over, like feeling me, like what are you doing? Started getting that. He was like, oh, I'm not gonna get anything today. My intentions have flopped and I cannot force her. I was just like, oh, yay. And then this is the part where freaking Kebab started getting weird. So he saw like he couldn't, you know, get at me, and I was not gonna fall for those tricks because I'm not that type of lady. So he started acting different. Like, okay, he took his arm off, he got the hint. And then I remember he checked his phone twice, okay? The first time he checked it just to like see the time, like, and then he just chilled out. And then he checked it again. There was, let me tell you guys, there was nothing to look at on his phone. He like checked it again. He did this, he checked it again. And then he went, oh, hello? No one was calling him. No one is calling you. Why are you picking up a phone? I noticed because I was like, I'm the type to be like looking like this, like, oh, I'm vibing, but I'm gonna cut my eye and I'm watching everything. Like, he said hello and he got up.
And then he goes, oh, I'm going to the restroom to answer this phone call.
Okay, go to the restroom, but no one called you. So he goes to the restroom, so does whatever he does, and then he comes back out, you know. And then he goes,
my cousin just called me, I'm gonna go outside and talk to him some more.
Basically. So I was like, oh yeah, whatever, not thinking about it, giving him the benefit of the doubt. Like, you know, it's our first time meeting, so like, I'm not gonna judge you, but in the back of my head, I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, go outside. So he goes outside and he stays for a really long time. So I was already chilling, like I was already having a good time by myself, like with him or not, I'm here for a good time. So he goes outside and I started noticing like, oh my God, this guy has been out there for a long time. And then I get a text. I'm like, why are you texting me when you're outside? Come back in and tell me what you need. Text was like,
oh, my cousin got ran over by a car.
What? Like, why can't you just come back in here and tell me that? At least say goodbye to me. He was just like, oh, I'm so sorry. I have to go right now. He's in the hospital. There's nothing I can do. I'm so sorry. I have to go. So he left. I was so mad, you guys. Yeah, he fled the coop. His cousin got ran over. Basically, he ordered a bunch of stuff before I got there. And then we ordered more stuff because I was there. So I just paid the bill and I went home. And on the way home, every red traffic light, I was texting. I was like, oh my gosh, how could you do that to me? Like, you should have told me. If you don't want to be on a date with me, just tell me. Just, you're not going to hurt my feelings. Like, just tell me, like, don't use me like that. And he was like, victim blaming. And he was like, accusing me of not trusting him. I was like, not trusting you? Only another day, like, that was not very nice. He's like,
my cousin is in the hospital. Like, how could you be so insensitive?
I'm like, you know, that's BS, basically. And even the next day, I was like, so when are we gonna reschedule for this day? Because you freaking screw me over. And you know what? I just freaking blocked him. Like, I was so mad, I was so annoyed. He's so lucky I brought my wallet, otherwise I would have been washing dishes in the back. Like, if somebody's that persistent to see you, wouldn't you think the same thing? Comment down below, because you fooled yourself. But yeah, that's the story about how I got scammed on my first Tinder date. I hope you enjoyed. I'm gonna have more story times. I haven't been posting, I know. But I have more vlogs coming, trust me. Like, comment down below if you guys wanna see other things. Yeah, comment down below. All right, thank you, subscribe, peace. If you show me what you need, then I'll never go MIA.